everybody. My name is Matt Elliott, and I'm here at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon on Highway 99. Today, I want to show you a rig that just came in. This is a 23D Nash. Now, I own my own RV from the same company I have an Arctic Fox. Nashes and Arctic Foxes are hand-built trailers that are made right here in Oregon, and they're specially designed for extreme climates, and they're very durable. I've had mine 14 years, and I love it. So I'm excited to show you this rig. Now, the 23D is a great trailer because, first of all, it's really not that big, but it's still got a queen walk-around bed and a slide-out, and it's loaded with lots of features that Nash puts on their trailers, and some of them are quite unique. So let's take a look. First of all, I want you to notice that on the front of this trailer, a lot of trailers have really low sloped front ends, and what that does is the idea is it makes them a little lighter weight and perhaps a little more wind efficient. But inside the trailer, you get a lot less room in your bedroom. So when you see these large faces like this, they go up a lot more straight, you're gonna get a lot more room inside the trailer. Now, one of the things that's really cool about a Nash, look at how tall this compartment door is. This is tall enough to put a cooler in, and or you know, whatever you want. But when you look at a lot of trailers, these cabinet doors are a lot shallower. They go all the way across, but they're not tall enough to get much into. So this has got a tremendous amount of storage. And then also right located in this area is a battery disconnect switch. So it's really easy to walk away from your trailer and turn off any draw on your batteries. Another thing, as I mentioned earlier, these are for all climates. Their compartment doors are a lot thicker and a lot deeper recessed and gasketed, and that just makes them much better in cold climate. So I really like that. Right here, there's a panel adapter for a portable solar panel if you want to add solar. However, on this trailer, it came standard from the factory with a small battery tender type panel. I think it's about 45 watts, but the previous owner has added two very large additional panels that must go, I would imagine, 120 watts a piece. So you have all three of those up on the roof, tremendous amount of solar. That makes it really easy to maintain your batteries when you're storing it, or if you're staying for a longer stay and you're using battery power, that solar offsets your use. Now, we do have a power awning here, and that's great. It's an adjustable height awning, so I can change the pitch of this awning manually so that when I bring it out, it's already set up to have good water runoff, and I can do it at either end. That's so you can put the water where you want. Got a nice big entry handle, easy to get a hold of. Has alloy wheels, good looking wheels. One thing you'll notice on this trailer is it's got substantial ground clearance. A lot of trailers don't have a lot of clearance, and if you're driving into rougher, unimproved areas, you're not gonna get quite as an easy time. This avoids a lot of problems when you have ground clearance. You can see that we have a larger hot water heater. This is a gas electric hot water heater, 10 gallons. Most trailers this size are gonna have a 6-gallon hot water heater. As we go around, oh, I like to point this out. You never see mud flaps on a trailer. And if you're going up gravel roads, you're throwing all that gravel up underneath your underbelly and beating the heck out of everything. And this really cuts down on rock damage to my framing and my underbelly coverage. So that's kind of unusual. It's worth noting. We've got stabilizer jacks on all four corners. If we come around the back, there's an outside shower here with hot and cold running water. Down here, there's a small receiver hitch. And what that is for is if you want to have, oh, a load platform or a bike rack or something that you put on the back, you can put something not too heavy. It's 200-pound hitch rating, so don't load it too much. Now, another thing, this trailer has a ladder. It's also got a roof rack, and you don't see roof racks anymore on trailers, but Nash likes to keep these things in play, and it gives you the ability to locate some things on the roof and tie them down if you want. That's really good. Now, as we come around here, there's a big surprise. Most trailers, they don't have a generator or any place to put a generator. They just haven't devoted the time and energy to do that. Onboard generators are nice because they're so convenient. And when it's built in like this, it comes with its own exhaust, and you are now a rolling power plant. You've got all that solar, plus you've got your generator here. 3,600 watt generator is all built in and ready to go. There's the exhaust pipe. Now you can go out and camp all you want and you never have to worry about enough battery power. You can do your air conditioning or whatever turns you on, and you've just got this ample supply of power. We do have a nice slide out over here. There's storage access in under the couch. And then on this side, we have even more storage. Now, the other thing I want you to know is that this is a true Four Seasons trailer. And what I mean by that is all of the plumbing, including my wastewater dump valves, are enclosed in the underbelly. So with this trailer, if I'm, let's say I'm going someplace really cold, like maybe I'm going on an elk hunt, if my furnace is on, my plumbing's okay and I don't have to worry. On mine, I just turn on the furnace when I think it's gonna freeze, so I don't even really have to winterize my trailer all the time. There's very little that I have to be concerned about if I've got that furnace going. So that is wonderful. Let's take a look inside. I'm sure you'll like that too. Follow me. All right. So now let's take a look at the interior. Now, the first thing you notice on this trailer is that it's really quite spacious. It does have a full residential queen bed right here, and whoever owned this prior put a nice big comfortable mattress on here. And then a lot of trailers are going to put a partition right here and make everything kind of private in the bedroom, but what it does, it has the overall effect of making the trailer feel a lot smaller inside. So this openness changes everything about what's in here. Now, as we look forward, we see that we have really good storage cabinets. So we have that big storage outside. We have this big storage under here. We've got hanging storage and shelves. These shelves are removable, so you can select how you want to use that space. There's even little nightstand boxes down on each side of the bed. The other thing I really like about Nash is the quality of the craftsmanship. You know, these guys are an independent company. They're not owned by, you know, Thor, Forest River, or any other big mothership. They're their own company. They hand build their chassis. They mill their own materials. They really do a great job of building. That's why mine's such a good rig after 14 years. Well, one of the things I really like on this is, see, all this wood, it's all real wood. And that, see that knot hole there? That's not a picture of a knot hole. That's a real knot hole. So the lumber in here is, and they have always been like this, is attractive, but it's also real. They do a great job of that. Now, this area here I want to point out, because this started out life with a kind of a horseshoe dinette, and not everybody wants the same stuff in their trailers. So these guys have taken out the horseshoe dinette and they put a settee in here. And so that's what's in here now, but there's quite a bit of room. And you could, if you wanted something different in here, you could certainly put it in. So, but that's a very comfortable seat. And then we come to the kitchen. So again, you know, really nice solid cabinet doors. These cabinets, by the way, are all screwed together. If you ever want to figure that out, you reach in behind, you're looking for pocket screws where they drill out the wood and then face frame these rigs together. The screws are indicating material of wood, not particle board. Like if you get a stapled one, you probably got particle board wood styles. Anyway, so we look up here, lots of storage, lots of counter space, big double sink. We got all the original books for this thing. Massive storage under here, even room for a garbage can. It's also nice to see you can easily access your water pump and water heater plumbing features from the back really easily under here if you need to do service. Big heavy duty drawers with drawer guides. Also, you see this is in the floor ducted heating. You see this duct here, there's one up in the bedroom. The heat blows throughout the coach through a single chamber, so it's very efficient, it's quieter, and it does also heat up those underbelly compartments where your holding tanks are living. That's why that works. Now, we do have a media center here. This is kind of an unusual feature. This rig can use a 12-volt television for dry camping, so if you don't want to have to turn on your generator to watch TV, you can just use this. That's a really cool deal to get a 12-volt TV. We got a nice big fridge with solid wood door covers. It's a lot more attractive. Okay, now what we haven't seen yet is the bathroom. One of the things in this design that I like is when the bathroom goes all the way to the back, it gets out of the way so the trailer feels more open. But I also get more room for the bathroom because I'm not trying to wedge it in between other features. So this rear bathroom design is great. Now, look right here. Go ahead, you go ahead of me. So if you look to the left, you see a really low step-in height on that shower. It's got a great skylight, so it's easy to get in and out of, and tall people can use this very well. It's got a nice medicine cabinet, big sink. A lot of bathrooms have pretty small sinks. And then it's also got a wonderful wardrobe space here. You're always short of storage. I don't care what trailer you buy, you always wish you had a little more storage. So this hanging storage makes a big difference. It's nice it's in the bathroom so you can just get your clothes and get dressed. Also has a porcelain foot pedal type toilet. And another thing that's really cool about this rig is that it's got a high capacity exhaust vent fan in here, and I can use that to blow all the moisture out and really ventilate this trailer well. Okay, one other thing I want to mention about the galley is that a lot of trailers today are coming without an oven or with a very small oven. So this one has both the microwave, the three burner stovetop with the high output burner. That front burner is a good one. And then we have the oven. Now, a lot of trailers have, if they do have an oven, it's only a 16 inch deep oven. This one's a 22 inch deep oven. That's the one I have. I've cooked a lot of stuff in it. It works really good. Another thing they've done is they've added a dynamite pantry space right here. Goes all the way back. All this shelving has lips so your cans don't come out when you're trying to drive. And so great galley. So that's a quick look at the 2018 Nash 23D that we just got in here at RV Corral. This is a really well-built trailer. I'm sure it would work really well for you in all climates. It might be something perfect. I enjoyed doing the video for you, and if you have any questions, give me a call. My name is Matt Elliott, and you can reach me at 541-954-8495. Thanks a lot. You have a great day.